I had to take a little video break because we had a bunch of guests over for Memorial Day. Not a bunch, social distance, blah, blah, blah. So I got the drywall up. I got the wood up. This is a really cool part. This is all a door to hide the water heaters, but still maintain access if anything goes wrong. A little bit of storage, that kind of thing. And then, not finished yet. I've got my bench and table installed and pulled down. So we gotta put another piece on that will fold down and be the legs. But this is held on magnets. I'm really excited to get this part finished. I got the drywall up last night. We got one more little piece to put on over here, so we'll go through that. Now I am by no means a drywall expert. I haven't really done it since high school. But turned out all right so far. But yeah, we're gonna get going. So I'm gonna remove this piece of trim here so that I can bring the corner tape down a little bit. I'm not gonna be mudding the entire wall because this is all gonna be covered. A little bit of cheating way, but it's all gonna look like that. So no need to mud all this, but I am gonna mud down to at least halfway down the where the trim is up top there. So I'm just gonna remove this trim board, fill in the big gaps, not big gaps, and yeah. The last sheet of drywall. I filled in the big gaps on the tops and sides just to make sure that when I put the corner tape on there, it holds good and it's got a good, there's no gaps there, nice and even. Time to put on the corner board.
No.
Vinyl corner bead. Supposed to use adhesive tape or spray. But I've already been to the store 3 times today, and I forgot that. So I'm just gonna screw it on there. Really don't want to hear about it.
No, it's not right.
Finished doing the drywall. I didn't want to show it because my drywall skills are quite embarrassing, but if you guys want to learn how to do drywall really well, I would refer you to the Vancouver Carpenter. His videos are great. He's very thorough and he makes it really easy to follow along. His advice was great. I suck at drywall, so didn't want to show that. We're going to be priming up here and along the top on both sides, and then we'll start getting the color on once the burner dries. Thank you.
able to,
in order to make this so that the door can open, I had to cut a 45 degree angle on this trim piece all the way down so that the door can open. I'll end up painting these all black so that it kind of hides where it is. And then this piece is gonna go right here, tight up against it. So you won't even see that this is an opening. Now, on the table part that folds down here, I am going to have to cut it down this line once I figure out exactly where I want this to go so that it blends in perfectly. But this will cut down this line so that I'll be able to open the table. I don't want to cut this board because there'd be a noticeable gap in the trim, and I just don't want that.